Shareholders of listed motor vehicle dealer CMC Motors will not hold an extraordinary general meeting called by embattled majority shareholders Peter Muthoka through his company and forwarders. The EGM set for the 21st of this month was called to dispose of the current board chairman as well as the chief executive Bill Lay. Andy Forders had gone to court to seek an intervention in what it called an infringement on its constitutional right as a shareholder to call for an extraordinary general meeting after the Capital Markets Authority blocked its bid to hold the EGM planned for Monday next week. The company claimed that the regulator had overstepped its legal mandate by blocking the meeting. On its part, the regulator filed a counter injunction requiring the court to uphold its decision as a regulator and maintain the status quo at the company in order not to interfere with investigations over alleged fraudulent dealings by Andy Forders, in which it alleged the company had defrauded CMC Motors.
Justice Ngugi dismissed Andy Forders' application and granted the CMA's application to restrain or to injunct Andy Forders from holding that meeting on 21st.
Well, the ruling on the petition between the CMA and Andy Forders may appear to be a ruling between the CMA and a shareholder, but going forward it may determine how powerful the regulator is when it comes to dealing with shareholders and specifically those associated with a listed company.
If this petition is heard, we should expect to see certain precedent-setting guidelines on what the regulator should and can do and what individual shareholders are entitled to do.
In the meantime, CMC's current management will continue to run the company, with the CMA carrying out its forensic audit on the company. For retail investors, their shares will remain suspended from trading until the regulator concludes its investigations and ends its suspension of CMC Motors shares. Henry Gethaiga, Citizen Business.